Hi everyone. Today we are going to see some of the questions related to trigonometry ratio. This is the first class in our series of trigonometry. Before that, we will be looking at what is Pythagoras theorem, what are Pythagorean triplet, and then we'll be looking at these questions. Let's start our today's first class. As you can see, these are some of the right angle triangles. In a right angle triangle, this one angle should be 90 degree. Opposite to that is always known as hypotenuse. And base and perpendicular are normally where student gets confused. So it depends upon the angle. Suppose angle is here, the given angle is here, which we call theta. The opposite to that is always what we call perpendicular. And the last side, which is remaining, is known as base. Now, if this theta changes to this side, other side. Now, if this theta changes to here, this perpendicular will shift here and base will shift there. Hypotenuse is always opposite to 90 degree. Is always opposite to 90 degree. And perpendicular is always opposite to theta. And you can say base is always adjacent to theta. So this is the basic information of a right angle triangle, because this is very important. In trigonometric ratios, we will be looking at these things in some time. Just wait and watch. So I'll give you these three questions and mark some of the things, and you tell me. So this is A, B, C. This is P, Q, R. And this is X, Y, Z. Suppose in this case, theta is here. In this case, theta is here. And in this case, theta is here. So you tell me in the first question, A, B, C, if theta is at C, angle C, what is perpendicular, hypotenuse, and base. So try yourself, because this is very important. I'll do one for you. So as I told you, opposite to 90 is what we call hypotenuse. So opposite to 90 is CA. This becomes CA. And opposite to theta is what? Opposite to theta is perpendicular. So AB. And the last side is base. That is, one second, CB. So that's it. Rest two of them are for you, your practice. So this is the first thing. And next is, like, you have to practice of your own first. Because if you don't practice, if you just look at the video, you won't be able to understand. Now let's move on to the revision of Pythagoras theorem quickly. Pythagoras theorem is hypotenuse square equals to perpendicular square plus base square. This theorem is very important for this chapter, because what they will do, they will give you two values, you need to find third value with this formula. So hypotenuse square equals to perpendicular square plus base square. So that's it. This is Pythagoras theorem. And for a quick thing, we need to learn some of the Pythagoras triplet also. So some of the Pythagorean triplet are 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 6, 8, 10, 12, 16, 20, 15, 20, 25. They become very handy. They become very handy if you know them. So if, as you can see, there is some pattern here. 3 double is 6, 4 double is 8, 5 double is 10, 6, 12, 8, 16, 10, 20. So this is how it is going. 3 into 5, 15, 4. So important one is 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5, 5, 12, 13, 7, 24, 25. So these are very important, which will be useful in the coming questions. So before moving ahead, let us look at some of the trigonometric ratios. So some of the trigonometric ratios are sine, cos, tan, cos x, sec, cot. So these are 6 trigonometric ratios. Okay. The thing is, how to learn is important. I use some of the mnemonics. You can make your own mnemonics. Let me just show you a right angle triangle, which we just saw. Let us take theta is here. So this is perpendicular, this is base, and opposite to 90 is hypotenuse. So PBH, we have to recall. So sin. Sin in English is what we call something which is very bad. So in Hindi, we call it pap. So I learned it by pap hai. With the cos, I have a feeling of a ball. We used to play with a ball named called Costco. So we call it Costco ball hai. With tan, I associate tension. So with tension, BP increase. So see here, P upon B. Or I will call it by B upon P. A reverse of that. Now, rest all three are reverse. So remember, sine, cos, tan, cos sec, sec, cot. Sine and cos sec are reciprocal of each other. As you can see, I mentioned here, cosec equals to 1 upon sine, that is h upon p. So this is p upon h, this become h upon p. Sec is opposite to cos, and cos is b upon h, therefore sec becomes h upon b, similarly cot b upon p. Okay, these are 6 trigonometric ratios. And now we'll be looking at some of the questions. First question. Let's do them quickly. In a triangle ABC, right angle at B. Right angle at B. A, B, C. You can take A anyway. AB equals to 24. AB equals to 24. centimeter, make sure you write unit. BC equals to 7. BC equals to 7. Okay. And you need to determine sine A, cos A. Sorry. 7, 24, 25. We just did. So you can write using Pythagorean triplet. I got this thing as 25. Remember, hypotenuse is the longest side. That's why it should be longest. Don't make silly errors. Hypotenuse is the longest side. Now they are asking us to find sine A. Sine A. This means angle. This means that theta is at this place for this particular question. Sine is P upon H, perpendicular upon hypotenuse. The perpendicular is opposite to theta, that is CB upon hypotenuse is opposite to 90 degree, that is CA. Okay, so answer is CB is what? 7, 7 upon 25 is the answer. That's the first part. Hopefully you find it easy. Next is what? Cos A. So they are asking us to find cos. Cos is ball hai. B upon H. B is base. Base is what? 24. Hypotenuse is again 25. If you can reduce it, you must reduce. That's it. This is the answer. So hopefully you understood the question, how to do it. Let me just now coming back to the next part, sine C. Sine C. Again, as I told you, this is the angle. That means theta is here. That's why I gave you the first exercise. You must do that. Sine C is, sine is what? Pap hai. P upon H. Perpendicular. Opposite to theta. Whatever I'm saying, just recall, remember, say it. P is what? Opposite to theta. That is 24. Hypotenuse is opposite to 90. That is 25. So answer is 24 upon 25. Hopefully you can do part C of your own. Now coming to second question. They are saying in the figure 88.13, this is the figure, find 10p minus cot r. So 12, 13, and what should be the next value? I don't know. So you can do hypotenuse square, 13 square equals to 12 square plus x square. 13 is 169, 12 is 144 minus 25. So root of 25 is 5. So x is 5. So you got this value as 5. So this value is 5. So this value is 5. Now they are saying find 10p. So they are saying theta is here. 10p. 10 is BP. Base. BP. BP badhta hai. I recall it this way. Okay, what is perpendicular opposite to theta? Opposite to theta. So that is 5. Okay, you must write QR upon base. Base is what? PQ. Because you are giving an exam. I am right now trying to teach as many questions as I can in the very taking less amount of time. But in exam, you must write all the steps. Make sure. So QR is what? 5 and PQ is what? 12. So this is the ratio. Many must be thinking, so why you're not writing centimeter? So centimeter upon centimeter got cancelled. So we don't need, because this is a ratio. trigonometric ratio. Ratios does not have any unit. Okay, next part is cot R. Cot R. I don't give a damn about this angle. R is what? Theta. Cot. Cot is opposite to tan. So it is BP. Base upon perpendicular. So that means it is reverse of this. Okay. Base. Base for this theta. Make sure you remember theta has changed. The base for this is 5. And perpendicular is opposite to theta, that is 12. 5 upon 12. The same answer. So this would be 0. Subtracting both of them, that would be 0. Hopefully you understood this part. Now moving on to the next question. So next question is question number 3. So as we know, sine A is nothing but PAP hai, P upon H, and the ratio is 3 upon 4. Since it is a ratio, that means it is in some multiple factor. Therefore, I can say perpendicular is 3x and hypotenuse is x. Using Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square equals to perpendicular square plus base square. Hypotenuse is 4x square, perpendicular is 3x whole square plus base square. So this is 16x square. I'm taking this 3x square to the other side. That is 9x square equals to base square. So 16 minus 9 is 7x square. And taking this square to the other side is square root. So therefore I can say base is what? X root 7. So we have base, we have perpendicular, we have hypotenuse. Now we need to find cos A. Cos A is nothing but, as we recall, ball hai, B upon H. So ball X root 7 upon hypotenuse is 4X. X and X got cancelled, so cos is root 7 upon 4. Now, tan A. Try yourself, try to recall what is the ratio. It's by tan, I remember, BP. BP increases. So perpendicular is 3x and base is x. Root 7, x and x got cancelled. So answer is 3 upon root 7. That's it for now. Hopefully you understood the question. Fourth question. See, homework is very important. If you are not doing your questions of your own, just looking at the video, watching all the answers, thinking you will clear everything, every concept at the end, sorry, you will be like amazed to see, you won't get anything, and then you will be terrified. So make sure you do all the questions. Now 15 cot A is 8. Okay, so this is a very important question. Make sure you mark important, because this is different from others. This is a ratio again. Think logically. This is 15 into. So can I also write it as cot A equals to 8 upon 15? What do you think? So again, this question is same as question number 3. So cot is what I'm telling you, that thing. Cot is what? Remember tan, BP. That DP is from down to up. This is up to down. So 8 upon 15. So I can say that base is 8x and perpendicular is 15x. Find hypotenuse and do the rest of the question. Cool. Now, question number 5 is also similar. Hopefully, you will be able to do it. Sec. I'll just recall for you. Sec theta. Sec. Sine, cos, tan, cos sec, sec, cot. Sec is opposite to cos. Remember, cos is what? Ball hai. So try to recall the way I'm doing. Ball hai. B upon H. This is B upon H. So sec is H upon B. Okay. So H is what? 13x. B is what? 12x. So do it yourself. Find all other trigonometric ratios. That means you need to find all other. That means how many trigonometric ratios are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 trigonometric ratios. 1 they have given. That means in total 5 you have to find. Hopefully you will be able to do this. Now coming to the next question. Question number 6 onward. We'll be doing in the next class. Till then, make sure you do all the 5 questions. So these 5 questions are your homework. See you in the next video. Thank you for watching.